So what is going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. And today's video, well, the Scathelock is back. And some of you guys probably have no idea, probably like, what? Scathelock? Who? But loads of you were commenting on a Scathelock video I did like 3 years ago, like all day yesterday. So I figured, you know what? Let's get in there and make a video on this gun since you guys are, you know, so interested in it. But yeah, one I remember, some of you won't remember. But yeah, this is it. It's a Kinetic 600 RPM auto rifle and it's coming back to the game in Season 15. So we're going to take the static roll, which you can see under pressure, tactical mag, model 8 loop. We're going to take this into Crucible and see how it does. But before we do that, guys, we do have a quick word from today's sponsor. Stop whatever you're doing, guys. It's time to get some Raid Shadow Legends in your life. Have you taken down the Demon Lord or crushed the Ice Golem? Have you gone into the arena? Have you collected over 600 champions blessed with unique skills? Well, you can build your team now today in Raid Shadow Legends. Use my links below to download Raid for yourself to your mobile phone or your PC. Today we're doing my top 5 favorite champions, and I had to start with Jizo of the Lizardmen. He's an epic defense champion with some very, very powerful moves and so much HP. I absolutely love my boy Jizo. Coming at number 2, we've got Tayrell. This is my first ever epic champion. He's also a defense champion with some awesome moves from the High Elf faction. And coming up next, we've got Delver from the Dark Elves, one of my favorite factions. She's an epic attack champion with so many awesome moves and abilities. And next up, we've got High Khatun of the Barbarians, an epic support champion. We've got a really good mix of abilities here with our champions. And my final champion, and perhaps my favorite, coming in at number 5, is Marquise. He's a rare defense champion, but he has the unique element that basically means he can take on any kind of damage type in the game, and he has so many awesome moves. He is from the Demon Spawn. So, what's new in Raid? This month, Raid has just released a ton of amazing new clan features and improvements. There are brand new quests for you and your clan members to work together on, new benefits for every clan member just for being in a clan, and even a brand new clan shop that gives you access to some incredibly powerful items. I like playing with other people, so I love all the new content for me to explore and complete with my clan. This month's also got new champions to collect from fragments in the Doom Tower and a load of events and competitions to take part in. So guys, if you want to get a huge head start in Raid, all you have to do is click the link in the description or scan my QR code and you get an epic hero, Chonoru, who is amazing in the Doom Tower. 200k silver, 1 XP boost, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard, so you can summon an awesome champion as soon as you get in game. All of this treasure will be waiting for you right here, and don't forget guys, these rewards will only be available for the next 30 days and only for new players. Once you're in, you can find me in game under the name DFP Shake, and if you're fast, you can even join my clan. And it's that easy. Click on the links in the description, and I will see you in game. Welcome back, guys. I hope you enjoyed that Raid Shadow Legends ad, you know what I'm saying? But we've got plenty of Destiny 2 gameplay coming up for you in this video. We are using the Scathelock. This weapon is returning in Season 15. Obviously, I showed you guys the static roll that I have from Year 1. Obviously, if you unlock this weapon in Year 1 and you want to give it an early try, you can just pull it from the collections. Boom. Very simple. Very, very simple. So, what is cool about Scathelock? Well, I've always been a fan of this weapon model. And the reason why I'm a fan of this weapon model is because of the sight possibilities. So this thing can come with Model 8 loop, and it's a really, really nice extra zoom scope. Very similar kind of effect to how it works with the Multimac, right? You guys must be familiar with the Multimac CTX. Well, Multimac is very much enhanced by this sight, and it's no different for the Scathelock. It gives it extra range, it gives it extra zoom, and it just seems to add on to the consistency of the weapon. Now, if we were to combine this sight with some really interesting perks, then this will be a very viable weapon for auto rifle enthusiasts. I just got no scope melee, by the way, ouch. And yeah, that is one of the things about this gun. Now, one thing I wanted to mention, if anyone at Bungie is watching this video, in fact, well, there's no point, even if they are watching, it's too late now anyway, because, you know, everything's probably ready to be shipped. But they brought back the future war cult weapons this season. And one of the things they did is they changed it from having sights to barrels, and that really sucked. Because obviously, you know, there are certain sights that are way better than others. And if you stick it with a bad sight and give it barrels, then it really hurts the weapon. For example, the stochastic variable cannot roll with the torch sight, and that really, really lessens the value of the weapon, in my opinion. Same thing would apply here if they were to lock this to like some basic iron sight. That would drop the value of this weapon to players pretty much, you know, extensively, really. Or, you know, a lot. I don't know what word I'm looking for. I need my thesaurus. But yeah, I really hope they don't do that, because that would suck, basically. We need our choices, or if you're going to put barrels on the gun, then just choose the best sight, which would be this or Model 6, you know? Yib is one of the good sights if you're going to stick barrels on the gun. And also, this weapon has under pressure, and you know what, man? It's actually really noticeable. This weapon has a pretty big mag size as well, so like, you know, you get halfway into the mag, under pressure is going to kick in, and then you're just going to be absolutely lasering people. And if you want a 600 RPM auto rifle to be effective in this current sandbox, then you really want to hit as many crits as you can to get that really solid TTK. If you miss a single crit or two, then you're going to be in trouble, because obviously the TTK will drop. And of course, auto rifles have that intrinsic weakness of, you know, not really accurate in the air. You can't peek shoot with them, so on and so forth. Obviously, hand cannons are, you know, way better than this weapon. But, you know, that's kind of the case for most primary weapons in the game. The only weapon types that will compete with hand cannons are ones that have significantly better time to kills. Like, for example, a Multimax CTX will absolutely obliterate a hand cannon player in the correct ranges. You know, some pulse rifles can two burst. I think 540 pulses with that 0.7 TTK and obviously 720 autos as well have a TTK that can really, really outshine a hand cannon. But obviously you have those other things I just mentioned, you know, peak shooting, inner accuracy, so on and so forth. You don't have those things. So obviously there are some weaknesses with using, you know, anything but a hand cannon in Destiny. Personally, man, I've been playing this game since year one. Since the very, very beginning, and I quickly picked up hand cannons pretty early on, and I'm just kind of over it, man. Like, don't get me wrong, I still like using hand cannons, but I'm approaching like 70,000 hand cannon kills. So, you know, I don't know. I feel like you can always switch up your primary weapon more so than you can your special. So I like to switch up my primary, so I'm looking forward to giving this thing a try. Next season, it's going to be a world drop. So, you know, it's going to come out from something like an Umbral Engram, for example. And if I get a Scape Lock, you know, I'm going to be like, ooh, what role did I get? What perks can it have? So on and so forth. And, you know, just the general feel of the gun, it's one of those. The feel factor on this weapon is high. Like, it just feels good to shoot in your hands when you get a hold of it. You'll see what I mean. And it was actually pretty popular right at the very beginning of Destiny 2, Year 1. It was one of the more popular weapons, actually. 450, sorry, not 450, just auto rifles in general. At the start of Destiny 2 were very strong, and this weapon's consistency and its relatively solid perk combination of under pressure, high cal, you know, model 6 or model 8, it's a really solid perk combination. Now, I was using high cal in the gameplay you're seeing just because I felt like, you know, tactical mag is an absolutely top tier perk. It gives you a bit of stability, gives you a bit of range, gives you more in the mag. It's a great perk. But the thing is with tactical mag is that, you know, it doesn't give you what high caliber rounds can give you, and that is obviously a lot of flinch, right? And I figured with the TTK on this weapon being kind of mid, you know, having high cal and hopefully flinching players and making them miss a few shots is really quite important with this weapon, because obviously the TTK is, you know, it's decent, but it's an auto rifle, so any missed bullets or any missed crits and that TTK no longer is competitive. High caliber rounds visibly was making players kind of miss their shots and struggle a little bit. So it definitely felt like the way to go for me. Don't know how you guys feel about that. I feel like high caliber rounds is more effective on fast firing weapons. With this being a 600 RPM, it just feels like a good fit. Of course, when it comes in season 15, it's going to have a bunch of random rolls. And hopefully Bungie really nail it with the perk selection. Maybe a couple of new perks could go in there. Who knows? But Scape Lock will definitely be an interesting weapon. And just based on the reaction to like a really old Scape Lock video of mine, the last couple of days since season 15 was announced and obviously the loot and everything, a lot of you guys have been leaving comments on that video. So obviously this is a weapon that holds a little bit of popularity, you know, kind of like there are just some guns that are just more popular than others for no particular reason. And it's a great gun, but like, you know, I don't know, people just love this weapon. Kind of how like they love Half Dandy in a little bit. Although Half Dandy is an absolute truck, you know, it's an absolute tank. They should bring that gun back with Kill Clip. Oh my god. I don't think I would take that gun off if I could get it. A tap the trigger, half Dan D with Kill Clip and a high zoom scope or a medium zoom scope. Oof. Bungie, you know what to do. You know what to do. And no, I don't mean Chaos Reach me in Rumble. Definitely don't do that. I was wondering how this guy got his second super. Well, he's getting the most out of his Geomags while he still can, I guess. I don't know. But anyway, guys, that's the end of the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Shout out to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this video. Check out the links in the description if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.